we got our, over on YouTube anyway, I think it's going to be our game of the day, not the game of the week, though. It's going to be Just Shoot 'Em versus Freelancer United Nation. Don't want to miss that.
Absolutely. And it looks like preparing for that right now. And looks like we've got the matchup. I'm just getting some names changed around here. Make sure nobody's misrepresented.
All right, guys. So what we're going to be seeing here, of course, is one of the old-timer teams versus one of the Season 2 teams that had their birth here, basically. So the teams are basically saying we won round one already, or somebody won round one. I guess they met in a solo queue game by chance. So that's going to be interesting. Maybe they felt each other out. We're going to see a good old-fashioned slobber knocker here from the beginning in this matchup here in round number two. Game number one versus Just Shoot 'Em and Fun.
Yeah, definitely excited to see this one. These are two of those teams who I believe they haven't actually played each other before, but appear to have some pretty similar skill sets where they come in. Of course, Fun has about a 50% win rate, if I'm not mistaken. Just Shoot 'Em is doing quite a bit better, but they, of course, did play very, very well last season, coming in third place. Not doing quite as well this season as their performances as we saw late season. But, of course, that is always up for a little bit more improvement. There are a lot more teams coming out this season as well, so a lot more unknown factors than there were last season, adding to that whole fact.
Yeah, and it looks like the teams are in the custom match sitting there ready to go. So we're going to go ahead and get them into the draft phase here and let them go at it. So we'll see what they come up with. Let's see. Perhaps Just Shoot 'Em is going to be the home team. So they get the map pick, I believe, based on the position of the names on the webpage here. I think that's the good indicator.
Yep, it is. Just Shoot 'Em is the home team this time.
All right. All right, looks like we're just hanging out for just a quick second. So we have a little bit more time to talk about these guys. So that's really good. Basically, like Septimus was pointing out, Just Shoot 'Em, the third place team in last season's tournament. So they ended strong. They did the whole season really strong, and they had a really, really rough start here. Season number two, in the first couple of weeks, they were really struggling with these teams, the matchups that they had. Could be argued that they had a pretty solid, pretty difficult matchup. However, they are expected to kind of perform, since they did last season. So now in week number three, they had a little bit of a resurgence in picking up a lot of points that they desperately needed. Now week four, if they start dropping games again, they're going to be in serious trouble of falling out of that tournament position.
Yeah, definitely. And they do have some really great players on there. Of course, several of them ended up on the charts that, I've been passing off to Safil for him to display. Of course, we got Caradon on there. Actually, one of the players who has died the least in the top 10, died the least so far in this season. Tied for 10th, I believe, with an average of basically only doing one death every four games. So he's pretty strong.
Good, yeah. All right, looks like the draft is going. I saw Evo's Laboratory was the pick. So Just Shoot 'Em wants to play on that big dark map there. Now, of course, Freelancer United Nation had the first ban. They're going to ban out Grimalicious, which is a good ban against them. It's a targeted ban. We saw it last weekend as well. Targeted against Caradon, get it out of his hands, especially on this big map. Celeste was followed up by Just Shoot 'Em with their ban, and now we're getting into the picks. So Just Shoot 'Em You had the second band, so Front had the first pick. They picked up Helio, then Just Shoot 'Em answered back with two of the best firepowers in the game, other than Celeste, Lockwood, and Gray. And then Titus was picked up as an answer for Freelancer United Nation, as you can see there. And then Aurora comes out for Just Shoot 'Em. And then a quick Knicks pick from Fun to answer back. So they get their last pick now, does Fun.
And Fun, of course, banning that Grimmo, just a direct shot across the bow towards Caradon, who plays Grimmo quite a bit when he can. Very good Grimmo player as well.
It's not surprising. Their most picked firepower for Just Shoot 'Em is Grimmalicious. When he's available, they pick him every single time. So it's definitely smart to keep it out of Keridan's hands. And the last pick coming in for Just Shoot 'Em is going to be that big Rast, the Rage Cat in there.
Whatever it
Even with the
takes.
nerfs, he is seeing a lot of playtime now. Not banned out anymore, but he's getting picked up a lot.
Yeah, and Blackburn coming in for Fun. Not a typical pick, but one of those that's actually starting to see a little bit more face time here in the league. So really interested to see. We actually Freelancer United Nation got a kind of interesting composition here. I was just taking a look at it. So you've got Helio and
Whatever it takes.
three fairly decent delivery systems. Of course, there's always that Fun Stealth Nyx Black Hole delivery system. Titus can rush basically across the entire map, and Blackburn, with the extended dash, can move five spaces right into an enemy team. The only problem with Blackburn, since he's usually jumping to cover, it sometimes impedes where he can actually pull people to.
Interesting strategies, but I don't think we're going to see like a Nyx delivery system for the Black Hole. If we do, it would be out of this world crazy against a team like Just Shoot 'Em, who has some of the better characters in the game on their side. The Lockwood, the Gray, really, really great on this map. Lockwood can stay super safe, shoot around those corners and get the bounce shots off. Gray, of course, with Rio, the drone, has that big AoE to scout out areas. Rask, of course, doesn't really care. He just runs around in Aurora, the long range AoE master of support. Now, really, what I would love to see here from what I wanted to mention before I get too lost in my train of thought here is we had a result from the Twitch side. If you guys are not watching, Cookie Cutters and Play for Fun played in their round number one on Twitch. They split the games, so each gets a point for round number one. Cookie Cutters and Play for Fun each won a game. Just to get you a little update there.
So Cookie Cutters and Play for Fun split it. So that's actually very interesting.
Five,
So, of
four,
course, those were some of the
three,
teams that were really
two,
vying for
one.
those lower tournament spots. So I'm curious to see how that will end up affecting, depending on how they perform for the rest of the day, because that could, put one above the other or vice versa.
Yeah, and Play for Fun is going to show up on our stream over on the YouTube side in round number three again. So they've got their work cut out for them. They're facing these mid-range in the standings teams just like they are at the moment. So it's kind of a really good matchup. So these are going to be pretty solid games, I think. But enough about that. We are getting ready for Just Shoot 'Em versus Fun right now. Just Shoot 'Em on the looks like should be on the red side unless the load screen trolls me again. They're going to be headed up by Hacksaw, the team captain, Caradon, like we talked about, C4 Saber King, and Awesome Zoss
Mission
showing up
started.
here today to play for their team.
Yeah.
And on the other side, let me take a look here as soon as we load in.
All right. Yeah, looks like the blue team is Just Shoot 'Em. Red team is Fun.
Yeah, and Fun, of course, does have a Legion in there, Inepti, Kochi, and Dizzy showing up to play today. So a solid lineup for them as well.
So it looks like Just Shoot 'Em splitting up. sending that one lone gray down to the south side, just to kind of scout out and see where everybody might be, while Funt's taking the opposite approach to that and just spreading out completely, staying in the back as much as they can, try and pull the other team
Your
in.
eyes playing tricks on you.
Hot potato. Hot potato. Yeah, looks like the Knicks, of course. Turn two, gonna win. Oh my goodness. Could it be? Could it be the Knicks black hole delivery system in action? Oh my gosh. What? I'm gonna lose it if this happens. I'm gonna lose my mind if this happens.
It's like he moved a little too far, although he could blow his one escape to jump in there, and it would be just glorious.
It would be glorious, but it would be the most ridiculous thing we've seen yet in the PPL. I would love to see it, but it would really mess Coach's rest of the game up. Nano
magic. It always is kind of a crapshoot there with Knicks not having any dashes, but when it does work, it works really well.
Now he's just going to do the AoE shot to get some damage down on their back line, so good job there. Black hole pops, but doesn't catch anybody in range, and we're lined up here. A lot of stuff going on in the middle of the map.
Yeah, it looks like we got Fun. Two members stuck out right in the middle with no cover. And Nepti standing right in the center as Helio, who is a little tougher than most, but still not where you want to be as a support.
Yeah, and here, of course, comes the shield out of Nepti, trying to save his firepower. But Legion from downtown flies across the map and actually takes a shot. I guess that was intended for Kochi over there, because it definitely missed Dizzy. Legion takes a shot there. It's probably not a prediction, but there it is anyway. Big time damage from the grenade out of Dizzy onto Caradon's head over there in the corner. And Haxel taking some damage, but gets a four-man knockback. Wow.
So yeah, that was actually very, very impressive getting that four-man knockback. Just another lesson as to why you should not group up when you're playing against top-tier teams. They will completely take advantage of it because now they are stuck in a group for a second turn, meaning they can just continue to lay in any kind of AoE damage they can get. Doesn't look like anybody can really take advantage of it this round, but
whatever it takes. Well, lots of shields coming out, but they can see C4 Saber King standing there staring at him as the gray. Why in the world Dizzy is not rolling here to try to avoid damage? I mean, you've got to know you're the target. You're out of cover. You're not the frontliner. You are the target, sir. Get out of there as soon as possible. And Dizzy, of course, she does do well most of the time, as far as I know. So it's really difficult to find out what they're thinking here. Kochi in a world of hurt there, being chased down by the Rask, getting beat on, getting slashed on, and we're getting ready for round number six, guys.
So I do have to say I do like their positioning here. They are trying to stay behind cover. Fortunately, they didn't have that same idea a little bit earlier. Caradon and Kochi stuck in there. Together, both of them probably going to exchange a little bit of damage.
Well, the big heal on Caradon means that exchange of damage is going to go into favor of Lockwood 9 times out of 10 there, unless something crazy happens. But of course, Kochi on the Knicks is surrounded right now, 1v4 literally on the other side of the map. This is not looking good, and there's the damage coming in. Not going to have extra damage from Awesome Sauce. He did use that big heal. And Axel, of course, no dash to help out.
And they are just incredibly spread out here. So, trying to see where this might end up going. Of course, Legion down there just with an empty. Just not a lot that can happen at this moment. Probably just going to see a lot of movement going on. C4 Saber King really needs to find somewhere to either heal back up or get close to his support.
Yeah, this game is a mess right now. A catalyst dash coming out of Kochi, so he does land on that buff. So I wasn't even there. I don't think it was there yet. But the bounce shot from Caradon is going to miss. Awesome Sauce is going to whiff as well, thanks to the catadash. Kochi is going to live one more turn at least, but he's chased down by the Rask now.
And just shoot him moving back, pulling into that little defensive area can sometimes work out for your team if you're really well coordinated. Sometimes, however, that can literally turn it into shooting fish into barrels. That we'll see if Fun is able to kind of capitalize on that close proximity they're all standing at.
Maybe they're going to send Legion in to go fishing with Dynamite here with that big Tidus bomb on his head. And oh, the unstoppable mod going to come out of Awesome Sauce here. And I guess anticipating maybe a catalyst coming out of Legion to try to catch them all with that black hole. But Hacksaw on the other side and Carrotan going to finish off Koji's Nyx. He was in a bad way ever since about turn number four is when that started to look south for Nyx.
And that black hole didn't even get a chance to get used. Awesome Sauce rocking that unstoppable mod on the Paralazer, seeming to be more and more popular in the league games recently. So it should be interesting to see where this is going next. Looks like Just Shoot 'Em's actually kind of pulling back a little bit.
Feel it coursing through my
Legion gonna
veins.
throw up that self-shield, that turtle tech
Ah,
there,
don't get
looking for
tripped
that
up.
damage to come in. Here's a trap from Keratin. Is that a free trap or not? I can't tell anymore. Probably is though. And oh man, the dagger's gonna pop on Awesome Sauce thanks to the grenade from Dizzy. And the ultimate, the Voltaic Cage is gonna come out of C4 Saber King. Two people are gonna go through it. Oh man,
Wow,
that was very well placed.
destroy me.
And Legion taking 60 damage there from not only the Voltaic Cage, but also the trap. That was a. They were just expecting him to go that one direction and that one direction only. Luckily, it was an excellent call this time around.
Yeah, we see over there right next to C4 Saber King, one of
You
those
must not
portals coming up.
fall.
He doesn't know it's there, and he's actually walking right towards it. Awesome Sauce, on the other hand, gonna heal himself up there with that self-heal on the Aurora. And at the on Helio, throwing an ultimate on himself. Nobody is even near the guy, unless I'm just blind here. But there's the dash out of Legion going on to Awesome Sauce. He's gonna get knocked back thanks to the self-heal over there. Rio doing a little bit of damage and a whiff from C4 thanks to the catalyst there. And not quite guessing. Keratin actually guessed it right, but just didn't angle it properly to hit Legion.
See, and things are about to get really interesting now. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ults on the field. Of course, Inepti just used their ult, but they aren't even around to use it on anybody. So nobody's going to be taking damage from that this time around. Except maybe Dizzy threw some cover. So, really curious as to what they threw that ultimate on themselves.
Yeah, I was really confused because nobody was around, not even another teammate, to really do damage to Inepti that turn. So that ult was definitely not necessary. Surprise there is C4 Saber King shoots off into nowhere because he tried to go into that square where Nyx is standing out. He's got to know somebody's standing there. That's why he didn't get in that brush. But the big ult coming out of Awesome Sauce, hitting two members of the enemy team there, and also healing Keratin up as well. Haxel finally taking in some of that Helio ult damage, helping him out, but the big
360
light him
no
up coming in.
scope.
Oh man, and here comes the 360 no scope from Koji. Just spawned in, taking out Gray, and Awesome Sauce is gonna fall as well with the combined efforts with him and Dizzy.
And Fun coming in here with the lead. That's really, really good at able to just combine that spray along with some just serious direct damage. Just once again, doing that math, deciding that Dizzy did not need to focus in with that single target attack from Blackburn there, but instead went for the spray to spread it around a little bit since they knew that would be just enough to take out the
Knowledge
enemy
is my
team.
gift, but still good.
Well, a lot of shields coming out here. Now is when Inepti needs that ultimate to throw on that big frontliner
They'll
of
never know
Legion.
what hit 'em.
Keratin ulting and taunting as well, going through the Helio wall, but gets two people with that big time Lockwood ultimate. Dizzy's gonna catch Hacksaw in his dash, trying to predict Lockwood most likely, but didn't quite catch him
Lion
there,
of my
Derek.
prey fights back.
It looks like Keratin now scrambled, kind of stuck out there, but no one really to take advantage of it, except for maybe Nyx. That would be a heck of an angle. I don't think it works out though. At this point, just shoot 'em really needs to kind of try and press the advantage with so many other members of fun at such low health.
Ooh, a big time Black Run ultimate catching two members, Carradine and Hacksaw, for 50 damage a pop. There's the bounce shot from Carradine. Even when he can't see him, he can definitely shoot you, seems like, if he has vision. And it seems to me the fun is just not coordinated enough today. They have Inepti off on his own most of the time, can't help the team. Again, the positioning is coming into play.
Yeah, honestly, it is. I'm trying to find things to talk about in this match, but it's really hard to pick things out. Just because, there's a little bit of everything going on here, and I'm not really sure how much of it is coordinated, how much of it's actually just kind of showing up as luck.
Well, Hacksaw is going to turtle tech and heal himself for the 15. He's going to get weakened as well. Legion's going to scream and shout at him. And obviously, with that self-heal, he can still do some damage to Legion. So is it going to be enough? The grenade coming out of Dizzy is going to miss, thanks to the dash from Carradine. And C4 Saber King is going to finish the job on a Dizzy from the other side. Hacksaw taking critical damage as well, even through the heal, and not going to be able to finish off Legion. Very nice trade there for fun. They needed that desperately.
Yeah, and Fun once again spreading their damage around because they are doing that math, laying it out, finding out what they can do to try and make sure they get as many kills as possible while maximizing their damage, not wasting it all on overkill. If you can do that math in your head quickly, you can really take the advantage in this game.
As they have, they're up 3-2, turn 15 coming up. Shield getting thrown onto Legion over there in the corner. Not sure if anybody has eyes on him from the other team. Probably not, but they may not even know that. But oh, C4 Saber King actually could have finished the job with Ryo, so nicely done there. An Ion Cloud coming out of Awesome Sauce, trying to predict some movement there, even though nobody was standing there, hoping they'd go into that little brush area, but no dice on that.
Stay focused.
Yeah, looks like they really kind of cut them off. I'm not sure if that is a healing Ion Cloud. I believe that is typically what Awesome Sauce runs, but that Nyx Drone has also kind of effectively cut that off from any kind of advancement through that area, preventing any healing at the same time. Of course, just shoot 'em has pulled back so far they can kind of heal themselves up as they need. But as it is, they really need to push their advantage and try to even the score up.
Ooh, Kochi taking a shot from Carradine over there on the gray, but not being able to return fires. So, oh, is that Carradine?
4 turns remaining.
Yeah, it is. Oh no, that's Lockwood. C4 Saber King got a shot on the Kochi, but he couldn't get that line back. Now Hacksaw's back in the mix here, and he is right where he wants to be, right in front of the enemy team.
Yeah, Legion really needs to get out of there as soon as possible. His death would pretty much even the score, well, would just even the score up. And so they need to avoid, especially this late in the game, if he can get far enough away, the rest of Fun can actually just completely avoid everything.
I
And,
love it.
man.
I'm sorry, I thought you were done.
Yeah.
I love the taunted dash. I'll take the fight to you, and then just goes the other way from the
Yeah.
Titus where he gets out of dodge.
So yeah, with only 2 turns left, Legion is way far away. If just shoot 'em can do a couple double moves and cut 'em off, they might have a chance to even it up before turn 20 is over. So very curious to see if that's the route they go or if they try to focus someone down. Inepti is not a bad target, but those Helios, man, they are just a pain to kill sometimes.
Absolutely, Kochi, gonna get that Helio shield to block that rash damage that's gonna be incoming for sure. But Awesome Sauce taking a lot of damage from right in his face there. Dizzy, a little bit out in the open, but in a good position to do damage to that immobile support.
And Legion, of
Two
course,
turns remaining.
circling the wall here, only 44 health. C4 Saber King does look like he is moving into position to try and sniff him out, though. The rest of the team moving into this one corner. Inepti, of course, like I said, a great target, but does still have their catalyst available, so maybe not the best target out there.
This is one of those concerns I keep having, with teams being down. Maybe they're banking on being able to find Legion before it's too late, but they don't seem to be as aggressive as they need to be right now to just force the issue and on fun and just force them into a bad position and have to fight back or die. But oh man, Awesome Sauce almost going down. Isn't enough. No, 2 HP left after Anethi goes down. Nice focus fire. And now Awesome has to back off, or that's going to be another kill.
And they've basically scared off the enemy team here for the final turn. Both Anethi and Legion could be finished off quite easily, but they backed off because of that aggressive attack onto Awesome Sauce. C4 didn't even move. Anethi now has his ultimate available to protect Legion from just about anything at this point. It's like only you,
but better. Yeah, and there he comes with the unstoppable mod on there. I love that. That means it's a three-turn ultimate, basically, that mod. Dizzy's going to take some light him up damage from Caradon. C4 is going to ult right on top of Legion, but I don't think they have enough damage, yeah, even with Haxall's ult and running through the Voltaic Cage. Can he be killed here? There's the ultimate. No, it's impossible unless more damage comes down, but here's not where it's going to come from. Kochi ulting with the Nyx. Where's it going to go? Two members almost taken out. Keratin. Keratin is going to fall, so that's 4-2 right now in favor of Fun. That's going to end the game. Defeat.
Wow, that was an excellent showing from Fun. Able to take down, just shoot him, take that early lead, and then hold it up the entire game. Finishing with that that escape, basically. They knew they were up, so what did they do? They didn't push the fact that they were trying to get more kills. They backed off and moved into a defensive position to prevent the enemy team from tying it up, which is something we've been seeing quite a bit, not only in the league, but I start to see that happening more and more often just in public games as well.
Yeah, definitely, and I wanted to point out, Legion never died that game. He was so close for like the last probably 6 or 7 turns, and he just kept surviving, kept escaping, finally got around to where Helio could help him out there. And that was probably the turning point when they were chasing him down, couldn't quite find the kill. That was probably the end of the game right there.
They're really excited to see where the second match goes, if Just Shoot Him can come back and return some... you know, do a little bit of return fire to him, maybe tie it up. But yeah, was actually, I'm not gonna lie, a little bit surprised there. I was expecting Just Shoot Him to take that game, but Fun, obviously having improved their game a little bit, just completely turned it around and took a game off Just Shoot Him without actually ever falling behind.
Yeah, they had the lead from the very beginning. You're absolutely right. And I'm sure Fun is happy to disappoint you that they didn't fall and roll over for Just Shoot Him. But, man, Just Shoot Him cannot afford to have this happen right now. Fun, of course, fighting for those positions, but so is Just Shoot Him, man. So both of these teams are at a very critical point in the season. Past halfway point now, we're in week 4 of 6. So we're more than halfway there. They have to get as many points as possible. So it's really good for Freelancer United Nation to get that first win in round number 2 against Just Shoot Him. That gives them the momentum moving into game number 2 against them to keep this momentum going and pull up that clean sweep. They really need that to get into that tournament and secure their spot on the leaderboard. But on the other end, if Just Shoot Him doesn't pick up a win here, I mean, where else are they going to pull points out this week?
Yeah, it looks like they are ready. Ready weapons. So we should get that draft going on here pretty soon. So really interested to see where this gets taken to, because, you know, of course, that last match we saw some fairly traditional compositions. Like we see with a lot of the teams who are really trying to take this to the next level, or definitely are the ones that are just kind of clawing their way into that top 6, which both of these teams are taking this very seriously, not trying anything different, going with what is tried and true instead.
Yeah, I mean, before today started, Play for Fun was sitting at 11 points on the leaderboard, 8-4 record. So they were in a really good position here. Now, Fun, on the other hand, was sitting at 6-6, so splitting all their games basically with 7 points. So they need these points a lot more than All right, here we go. Fun is 6-6 with 7 points. Just Shoot'em started this today out 5-7 with 7 points. So they're tied going into this series as far as points go. So whoever comes out on top here is going to take that spot away. And they may not be in sixth place just yet on the leaderboard, but it's going to be close.
Yeah, and of course, you know, if they, if they tie this up with a split, they will actually be at the exact same place, both tied up still.
Yeah, that's the dichotomy here. You know, you want, if you're just shooting, you want to tie it at this point. You can't drop another game, or they're just going to start running away. But we got a draft going on here, guys. I'm sorry, I rattled on and on and on. Cloudspire is the map, so that small, small map. Still another targeted ban, even on Cloudspire for Caradon on that Grim Relations from Fun. And Celeste being banned out by Just Shoot'em. Fun was the map selector, so Just Shoot'em got first ban and first pick. They first picked Lockwood, of course, and Heliotidus coming in for Fun as well once again.
Yeah, looking to see where Just Shoot'em is going to go. You know, with that Grim Relations ban, they do try to go for something else that has, you know, the maneuverability. But it is hard to make a choice for that one. Grim Relations brings so much to the table with Celeste being banned. It kind of takes away from that as well. They do go with Gray, the elusive one.
I was kind of surprised they didn't want to lock down the Asana. But, of course, seeing Tidus on the other side doesn't make you too pressed to pick up that frontliner right away. But I expected Asana out of Just Shoot'em this time for Hacksaw. Nick's coming out for Fun to answer that Gray. Maybe not the best answer, but it is an answer anyway in the draft phase, at least. And, well, here comes the Aurora pick out of Just Shoot'em.
Yeah, I mean, at this point, really all they have left is their frontliner and freelancer. Both teams have, you know, picked completely the opposite of what the other team did. So they kind of have free pick from what's left at this point, unless one of them just kind of decides to go with a three firepower composition or
I want to see that
similar.
Orion get picked up here. Devil support with Aurora. Oh, baby. Let's see it.
And they do have the firepowers to make that work as well.
Aw, come on, guys. But it is a Rask anyway. So Hacksaw is going to be on that Rask instead of Asana. I figured she was going to get picked up. And Blackburn's the final pick for Fun. So do they have the same team comp? That's my question.
Yeah, exact same team composition as the last game. Good to go. So we're actually kind of starting to see that a little bit where, you know, a lot of these teams who go up against each other have these specific compositions they've been practicing with. So when it comes down to the draft, if one of those isn't banned, you'll see both games end up being the exact same compositions for both sides.
Yeah, they definitely have the people that they like to play, and they have the team, the things that they've been practicing lately, the team comps, the strategies. Obviously, Fun likes this Heliotidus combo for the front line, and of course, the Blackburn Nyx for the back line. So, seen it twice in a row now. Looking to see if they could pull it off again. Guys at home, are they going to clean sweep Just Shoot'em here, or are Just Shoot'em actually going to come back and pull off a game to split the series 1-1? What do you say? What do you think?
Well, what do you think? Let me ask you that. So we've got Just Shoot'em and Fun literally tied up until that previous game where Fun went ahead by 1 point as it is. Could possibly be free if they sweep again. What are you looking at here when you're taking a look at these compositions and the histories of these teams?
I've got to say that Just Shoot'em has a really good shot here of bouncing back, keeping their mentality positive, and picking themselves up off the floor, basically pulling off game number two as a win for their side. They do have the team members to do it. They've got a solid maturity about them. I think Hacksaw's mentioned a lot of times a lot of their players are in their late 20s, early 30s, so they have the maturity factor, they have the focus factor there, and they maybe have the leadership factor in one of them being the morale officer, perhaps.
Yeah, and but they are one of those teams that don't necessarily split a lot. It seems like with Just Shoot 'Em, either they're going to completely take it out, or they're going to just, you know, not win a single game. Seems to be a little bit of a history with them.
Yeah, I would agree with that statement as well. I think it's spot on. But, guys, we're getting into this match. We're loading up for Cloud Spire between Just Shoot 'Em and Freelancer United Nation. I can't wait to see this one. The tension is high here because it's a lot on the line for both the teams.
Yeah, this is one of those matches where everything matters, because if one team takes it versus the other, it actually is going to change their position on the ladder.
Yeah, and basically, guys, if you don't know already, Season 2's prize pool is massive. For the tournament. Now, to get into the tournament, you got to be in the top six of the season as far as the points go. So the top six teams get in. Tiebreakers are going to matter, of course, in the end if we have any ties, but you got to get in there because we have first, second, third, and fourth place prizes now. So only two teams aren't going to make it in. So I think if Just Shoot 'Em can get in there once again, they're going to put on a good performance, but they got to get in there first. Back
into the end. And we got Just Shoot 'Em doing what seems to be a more and more popular opening for Cloud Spire, all piling down there in the corner. I'm still surprised every time I see this opener, because in my opinion, it's just ridiculous. I mean, I guess tactically it makes sense. On a map this small, the longer you can hide, the better advantage you have, but I think there's better ways to go about it.
Well, information is very important in these types of strategy games, because the more information that you have, the better decisions that you can make as a team and as an individual. So if they can hide long enough and they can start getting vision, which of course they didn't, hiding over there in the corner, then they can make better decisions than their opponents. But that Nyxtrap is going to catch Carrot in there, so no bueno.
So now this is a little bit more standard here, moving into a defensive position with, looks like Hacksaw over there on the side, and both firepowers behind that low cover, they're able to take solid pot shots through either one of the entry points coming into that little area. So curious to see whether or not they'll just kind of stick back here and wait for the enemy team to come for them.
Oh man, a nice Helio wall coming out just to block off a huge chunk of the map over there where they're all huddling up. Nice bounce shot onto Dizzy over there. Blackburn taking a lot of damage now from the back line of Just Shoot 'Em, and Nick's backed off so far, just out of position to do damage. Hacksaw maybe anticipating a dash in from Titus, but it does not come. He swings and misses.
Yeah, it looks like they are just going to stick back there. Once again, this is another popular tactic on Cloud Spire to move into one of these, two defensible areas and just try to let the enemy team come to you as much as they can. So they're really waiting for the tank to get in there. Once they can finish the tank down, they move on out and try to take down the range.
Oh, here comes Legion flying in there with that black hole on his head. Maybe he would have wanted waited one more turn to do that. He just got the black hole, in fact. There's Hacksaw taking a little damage from the backside as well. But Dizzy, back there at half HP now, carrying, getting a nice pot shot off on Inepti over there in the corner with the Helio as well.
So when Legion completely surrounded by the enemy team, C4 and Hacksaw may want to get out of there, but that wall is no longer a threat, so they're really only looking at 10 damage plus displacement, not really much of a threat. So at this point, if they all four lay into Legion, they could take him down a considerable amount.
Yeah, that would be probably somewhere around 100 damage. He's expecting a Turtle Tech and a Helio Shield coming out, so they think definitely they're going to stick around and start doing damage. Here's a Weaken coming out onto both Helio and Titus, and he weakens right back, so right back at you, I guess. The Dirty Fighting comes out onto C4, and a wall coming out, so there goes C4, wisely getting out of dodge. Hacksaw is going to go over the wall, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, on the angle there. Legion, they do finally break through those shields. Here we go. Hacksaw actually doesn't go because that wall was in the way, it looks like.
So yeah, it looks like Inepti must have used a brain juice very early to get that wall up a second time because he had just put one down. Unfortunately, didn't really pay off. We did get just shoot him split up a little bit here and pulled out of that little comfort defensive zone. And now they're out in the open where Fun has set up just a great killing area.
Shields up.
You must now, I like their position. Nyx is actually not in cover, but here's Awesome Sauce going at the taunted heal. But he's so far away from the action, he doesn't actually have to stand in cover because nobody could even attack him over there. Good job on that. Here comes Hacksaw trying to stick onto Legion. Gets the slowdown on the Titus, trying to keep him away from C4 Saber King, but he does get fired back on. And Nyx from downtown popping the dirty fighting. But man, look at that cover bonus saving the day for C4 Saber King. That was four people that attacked him, and he barely took any damage.
Yeah, but let's talk about that combo that just happened. We had Awesome Sauce throw that heal on the Hacksaw, who then, you know, got right next to Legion. Carradine threw that trap down, and even with just that one space knockback, was able to do a decent amount of damage to Legion and heal Hacksaw up at the same time just from that one small, often overlooked combo that's available.
Yeah, a lot of people don't expect that little knockback. Legion is getting out of there. He says, that's enough for me. Thanks, but no thanks. And it's only Inepti over there, really, to get some damage down. Except, wow, the super long range from Nyx. I think he's running that extra range mod on his basic, if I'm not mistaken. Big time damage coming down off C4 Saber King from Dizzy on the Blackburn. Hacksaw thrown Inepti. I guess he anticipated the Titus getting out of dodge.
Yeah, both teams playing just incredibly defensively. Even C4 moving their drone back to that defensive area to use as an escape rather than using it offensively, which he should be really doing in this case, moving it over to the enemy side since they're both basically forming two fortresses and drawing a line in the sand seems to be what's going on here. Just you
wait. Yeah, both frontliners just kind of backing off now. C4 is back with his team, so he's going to be fairly healthy fairly soon. That's the difference between a healer and a shielder support. You can heal the health back and it stays. The shield only lasts for that one or two turns in the ult case. Hacksaw ulting all by his lonesome over there in the corner. Going to be a sad rage cap because of that. And the drone does go out there, so good job there.
Yeah, that is one thing I do want to point out, like you were saying. Inepti is running Helia, which means their team should be playing a little more aggressively because what they're basically doing is giving Awesome Sauce a chance to heal up his enemy team. Helio has no way to do that, so as they get chipped away against, that is a permanent damage with the exception of the heal buffs, whereas Awesome Sauce can stand back there and heal those guys up all day long. Those shields are better for aggressive tactics.
Yeah, nothing really going on, just like we just pointed out. A little bit of healing coming out of Awesome Sauce, a little bit of repositioning, and here we go, turn 11. Oh, yeah. And so it looks like Hacksaw's looking to get back into the fray. He did pick up the health globe, so I would anticipate a dash coming out of him, but he doesn't really have eyes on anybody just yet. He's going to know there's a Nyx right there now because he's trapped. And Dizzy just going to take a blind shot into the cover there. And C4 slowly healing up there, but he trips. The Nyx trap goes right back down again.
Yeah, this is proven to be a rather... I'm just going to say it. This game is boring. These guys need to get in there and duke it out a little more. I know there's a lot on the stake, but you're not going to get anywhere standing around healing each other up. So it looks like there's a little bit more action coming out now that we have some ultimates available to everybody, though. So hopefully it'll speed up here soon.
And that, with that over the walls mod on the shield there, throwing out the black hole onto Legion. So anticipate a dash from Legion coming up next turn. Hacksaw's gonna dash this turn though, but Dizzy gets a nice three-person black burn, all 50 damage on each one. And Caradon ulted in only to take ridiculous amounts of damage on the Lockwood.
And it looks like we're finally getting that brawl we were hoping for. Dizzy got knocked down quite a bit with some team play there from both Hacksaw, Caradon, and Awesome Sauce, taking damage from three sources. Still only took him down to 56. And of course, Helio there waiting with his ultimate could easily throw it on him to, you know, switch back over to an aggressive positioning.
You, version 2.
Yeah, here comes the shields. And it's actually going to be onto Legion, the Helio ultimate. So, like I said, man, oh, the dash doesn't come out. Amazing. Caradon does dash. And Hacksaw does Cata dash as well. The only person taking damage from Dizzy is Awesome Sauce way over there behind cover. And here comes the ultimate. So, nice lineup there to get in range was Caradon to take that healing. A big grail from C4 Saber King going to protect Hacksaw over there. And hopefully, maybe get somebody thrown through it next turn.
Yeah, it doesn't look like anybody's going through that little walkway area, though. So that gray ultimate essentially wasted here, as there is no way for Hacksaw to knock anybody through it. Legion does have his dash up, so hopefully should be able to take advantage up. Basically, what's happened here is these teams have both run in, done a bunch of damage, and then split back up to their respective sides.
Oh man, here comes the dash from Legion onto Awesome Sauce. He is healing up slowly, but it is predicted by Caradon and Awesome Sauce, but that's not going to stop the damage coming in onto him. Now, there is a whiff there, but the darts do reveal Dizzy in the corner there. Oh man, here comes Kochi with that big time Nyx ultimate. It's going to take out Hacksaw, it looks like. Nothing is going to save him from that. He does throw somebody, but Inepti doesn't really mind. He's over in the corner in a safe position for the next turn.
So yeah, and here's where that real disadvantage comes out from both teams playing incredibly defensively like this. One of these teams, more specifically Fun, is going to really have to shift gears here and just shoot him, and become very aggressive, try to secure a kill as quickly as possible, because with the way the game's been going, there's only five rounds left.
Yeah, Titus gonna scream and shout, mind himself up, this is gonna use that second win, but I believe Legion's looking for that big time ultimate. Awesome Sauce getting a little chip damage from the side, a little bit of healing damage, but here's the big Titus ultimate. Almost takes Awesome Sauce down to critical levels. C4 with the long range attack over there onto Dizzy. Of course, knew where he was thanks to the reveal darts the turn before.
Of course, Awesome Sauce stuck where he's at right now. This could be another advantage for Fun if they could take it. But you got Inepti and Dizzy both looking pretty low down there. Fortunately, only C4 is really in range to take advantage of it, and if he can take down Dizzy and tie it up, this game is going to become a lot more interesting.
Yeah, that's a big if when there's a Helio standing right next to him with the shields available. Here's another wall as
so
well.
Sharp, you won't feel it yet.
And the taunted dirty fighting dagger coming out onto Awesome Sauce. Where is he gonna go? He actually is revealed on the catalyst dash, so very well done to do that. Expected that is Legion. There's the shot from C4 onto Dizzy, but Dizzy returns fire and almost takes out C4 with that big 42 shot.
Four turns remaining.
Yeah, a lot of different directions this game could go at this point. Awesome does have that dagger on him, but no one's around to pop it, it doesn't look like, especially with the fact that a lot of damages have recently been taken down to not be active damage. Dizzy's probably going to be the main focus here, but of course, like you said, that Helio is hanging out there trying to keep him alive as long as possible.
Well, there goes C4 Saber King going into the lion's den, if you will, over into enemy territory just to get away from all this damage that definitely would have taken him out this turn and had another kill for the enemy team. Fun. Awesome Sauce trying to hang in there, but he's low as well. Can't really get into
three
the fray.
Turns left.
Yeah, it looks like C4 has actually just signed his own death warrant here. Now with absolutely no escapes. Stuck right there in the lion's den, as you called it. And Dizzy not looking so hot himself. Could actually go down to just a swipe from Rask.
Alright, looks like another black hole coming out onto a Nyx again. And that's the... really making the question my life choices here. And C4 is going to go down, but the trade is probably going to happen there for Dizzy as well. Is it? Oh, yes. Yes, it definitely is. With the Rask ultimate plus the swipe, that's going to be the end of the trade that keeps them in the lead. So Fun still hanging in there 2-1.
And Fun actually really has a pretty solid advantage here as well. Awesome Sauce stuck out in the open. I don't know if Inepti can actually reach him with an attack, but Kochi can definitely start to whittle away at him here while the rest of the team moves into position to secure that third kill.
More and more shields. Seems like non-stop shields coming out of Inepti, so that's a great way to play that that Helio, always having it available. There's the Tynus dash, but the heal comes out onto Awesome Sauce, gonna knock him down so he can get away. Kochi gonna taunt that basic attack. Boom! There's a big time 42 damage shot from the Nyx. And Inepti gets thrown over the Lockwood trap. That's another one of those combos we'd like to see.
And Awesome Sauce doesn't move, staying exactly where they are. I mean, this is going to get that third kill secured here. Inepti probably in the most trouble at the moment, with Keridan just having got his ultimate.
Well, of course, Inepti does have that Kata Dash available and ready. Turn 20, so well done for an immobile character to keep that the whole game. There he does use it to avoid that Lockwood ultimate that would have probably brought him almost dead. But there's 3-1 in favor of Freelancer United Nations, taking out just shoot him with a clean sweep.
Yeah, that was incredibly calculated there. They left that Nyx behind knowing he could put out just enough damage while everybody else got out of dodge, making sure they survived. So Nyx able to get that final kill in on there to put Fun up 3-1 over just shoot him. Doing an excellent job, really showing a lot of improvement.
Yeah, no doubt about that. So I'm going to try to track down somebody from Fun's team and get them in here for that post-game interview, guys. Hang out for that. You don't want to miss it.
All right, and... so what did you think about that? So now we got Freelancer United Nation going up 3 more points. Just shoot them sticking where they're at. How do you think, let's see here. Who do we have Just Shoot 'Em going up against next? Just Shoot 'Em with their next game up against Trash might not be able to recoup any points from today because of that. So where do you think this puts Just Shoot 'Em at with their chances of getting into the top six there? Alright, well, it looks like we are still tracking down somebody, and Lothans is incredibly focused on doing that.
We've got Kochi, the Knicks player from Freelance United Nation, joining us now. Thank you so much for coming by. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. Hello, everybody.
Hello.
Doing fine.
Well, it's got to feel good to take down Just Shoot 'Em in a clean sweep there, man. 2-0-ing those guys, locking down those 3 points for your team, much needed. How does it feel to take down one of the season one vets like that?
Oh, it feels good. it always feels good. And it was a nice game, so it was a bit different than what we used to play, but we tried to build something different, and it worked. So we are quite happy with the team.
Yeah, and you guys were playing incredibly defensively that second game, as was just Shoot'em. I mean, how do you think that game could have gone a little bit differently? Because, you know, for the first really 14 rounds, not a whole lot happens.
Yeah, that's why it was different from the other games, because normally we always dive in and try to do massive damage as fast as possible. But when we saw that they were playing defensively and we had like a lot of range to with Nyx and Blackburn, so we just tried to poke them down and push them to come to us. And where they did a mistake, I think, is when they tried to ulti us in the middle, mid-game, because we predicted that they were coming. That's why Blackburn had a really nice ultimate in the mid. And that opened up the game a little bit.
Yeah, I did notice that. We did mention it actually during the cast. Was Keridan on Lockwood ulted in and took ridiculous amounts of damage as soon as he landed there on you guys. So that was a coordinated play where you guys basically knew he was coming and just punished him for it.
We were wishing it was coming.
Hoping for sure.
Exactly.
Let me see here. You guys have anything else? So you guys have played. Oh, you're coming up round number three as well versus Play for Fun. Now, do you guys need to switch things up for them, or have you prepared that far ahead, or you just kind of go with the flow when it comes right down to it?
Oh, we just watch every single team, how they used to play, and try to coordinate a little bit more, change maybe some few things, but we're just taking how it comes. So we like to be mobile and have some try to change the plays, so to be unpredictable.
Well, it's definitely working out. I know last week you guys had a good showing, and this week it's looking even better. So good luck with that. Septimus, do you have anything else for him?
Yeah, we're just kind of curious because you guys did pick Helio. You guys have, you know, picked Helio a couple times now, I believe. And I was just curious, what was your thought process? You know, Helio is not typically a stand behind and try to, you know, wear down the enemy. He's more of an aggressive support. You get in there, you shield the damage that's taken, and the shielding, of course, doesn't stick around for more than one turn, so it needs to get used up to be effective. Just curious, what made you guys go with the defensive route for that particular game?
We just wanted to try something different because NFC is very good with Aurora, but we know that a lot of teams loves Aurora as well. So we had to plan something else, some different kind of build and matchup. And we feel good with playing with the Black Hole and the Black Hole delivery system, like we like to say, to call it. So we tried a few start differently with Nyx, but didn't work twice in a row. Just to leave a little bit Legion a bit back to make him go in a little bit later. So that's what we did, just to change, because that's what we saw. They were waiting for us, so they knew that we... They know that we come normally in the front line. So because we changed that, I think they were a little bit destabilized maybe. So it worked. So don't know what to say.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, it's definitely an excellent job by you guys, and glad to see you guys continuing to improve here.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations. Is there anything you would like to say to the audience sitting at home, maybe your fans watching today? Before we let you go.
Just enjoy the show.
All right. Thank you so much, Coachy. And how do you actually pronounce your name?
It's because I'm French. So just to for you to know, Coachy is the French short name for coccinelle, like the ladybird. So normally in France, it's Coxy. So, but you can say Koshi or Kotsi. It's okay. I'm fine.
Okay. Well, good luck in your next matchup. We're going to let you go and continue on that trend. So
thank you. Thanks so much. All the best to everyone.